Hey friends, so glad you're here. I'm Becca Scott, and I'm gonna teach you how to play Video Vortex from Mondo Games. In this futuristic throwback to the days of VHS, players take on the role of mutants, duking it out in an arena of combat designed by Josh himself. Read the lore in the rulebook when you get some time, it's wild. Setup begins with the Vortex board placed center. Take the Vortex cards and place the following cards in the top row of the Vortex board as follows. Signal splitters, bargain bin cards, head cleaners, and damaged tapes. My nickname in high school. Set aside all the special interest and staff pick cards for now. Shuffle the remaining Video Vortex cards, which can be identified with the cost and genre on the top right of their cards, into a deck and place them on the bottom left of the board. Then reveal and place 5 cards from the deck on the tape spaces to the right. This area is known as the Vortex. Place the 8 suns face up below the board. Next, each player takes a player board, a runtime dial with a tens slot and a ones slot, 2 teal energy cubes, 1 red charge cube, and 3 Be Kind tokens. The Be Kind tokens are the main objective of the game. Once a player has collected 1 of each type of Be Kind token from their opponents, they win the game. Players choose 1 mutant to play in the game. Mutants have a complexity level below their name. For your first game, I recommend a low complexity mutant. Once you're an expert at VHS combat, try some of the more complex mutants. After each player has selected, they gain the cards listed on their supply list and shuffle them into a face-down deck. Cards labeled staff pick or special interest have the mutant's name on the left. Look for those to add to each player's personal deck. Place the mutant sheet into the player boards with the runtime and powers face up. A mutant's runtime is effectively their life points. Once the runtime on their personal dial exceeds the runtime on their mutant sheet, that mutant dies. More on that in just a sec. Place the 2 energy cubes in the left track and the charge cube in the right track. The player who selected last in the mutant selection takes the first player marker. All players now draw a starting hand of 4 cards from their personal deck. Before we dive into gameplay, let's take a look at these cards. Cards can have a cost in the top right, which is the amount of money needed to rent it from the Vortex. A genre, which includes action, comedy, horror, or sci-fi. An energy cost on the left side, and a card type on the right, either SP for standard play, which will be discarded at the end of a player's turn, or LP for long play, which can stay in play over multiple turns. LP cards also have a runtime and can be targeted just like mutants. There's an effect in the text box and bonus abilities like syncing, which activates when 2 cards of the same genre are active in a player's area, and free with rental, which gives the player a bonus when they rent the card from the Vortex. Some cards forward and others rewind the runtime dial. Forward can be used to advance opposing mutants' runtimes, inching them closer to death. Rewind turns the dial back for a mutant, extending their playtime a bit longer. Other cards provide money and actions. In all these cases, there's no pieces to track them. Players add these values in their noggin when playing and spin them accordingly. Gameplay occurs in rounds, each divided into 3 phases: sun phase, action phase, and end phase. First up in the sun phase, beginning with the first player and proceeding clockwise, everyone selects 1 sun card, placing it near their player board. Each sun has a unique power that can be used in the action phase. Beginning in the second round, the first player marker passes to the left and players return their used suns before selecting a new one. Players cannot have the same sun 2 rounds in a row. Next up, the action phase and end phase occur in turn order for each player. The first player will go through their action and end phases, then play passes clockwise until all players have gone. After that, a new round begins with another sun phase. In the action phase, players can use their cards and sun to forward their opponent's runtime and rent new cards from the Vortex. On their turn, the active player may take as many actions as they are able in whichever order they want. They can do the following. Play cards from their hand, provided they spend energy from their track equal to the cost of the played card. Spending energy doesn't return it to the supply, it's just added to a player's area. Cards effects trigger here, and played cards remain in play until that player's end phase. LP cards will stay even longer. Players can also spend charges to activate a power on their mutant sheet. They can activate their sun power by exhausting it. This means turning it 90 degrees. They can spend money to rent cards from the Vortex. Renting cards adds them to a player's hand, which means they can be played that turn. Immediately fill empty spaces on the Vortex with a new card from the deck. After a player has completed all their actions, they move to their end phase. They discard all cards from their hand and SP cards in their play area. They unexhaust all cards and their sun, then flip their sun and follow the instructions. Return all spent energy to their track and gain one energy. Gain one charge to their track, two charges if their energy is already maxed, and draw four new cards from their personal deck. If a player must draw cards and no cards remain, they shuffle their discard into a new deck. Players continue with action phases and end phases until all players have gone. Rounds continue with players increasing opponents' runtimes and renting new, powerful cards from the Vortex. Some important concepts. When forwarding, a player may only apply the forward to one opponent on a turn until that opponent dies. If they die, the player can target another player on that turn with additional cards. Excess forward does not carry over to another opponent. Remember, when a player's runtime dial exceeds the runtime on their sheet, they die. The player who dealt the killing blow may take one Be Kind token from the top of their victim's board and add it to their personal trophy area. The dead mutant resets their runtime to 0-0 and play continues, because mutants always come back for the sequels. Once again, Be Kind tokens are the main objective of the game. A player must acquire one of each type of Be Kind token from other players. If a player kills a mutant who has no Be Kind tokens on their top area that player doesn't already have, they may instead steal a trophy from that mutant of the type they need, but only in this special circumstance. And that's the basics of Video Vortex. Players continue their forwarding and rewinding until one player has acquired three Be Kind trophies, one of each type, to win the game. Thanks for watching this How to Play video from Mondo Games. You can head to your local Alamo Draft House to pick up a copy. And remember to be kind and rewind, kids.